بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. Peace be upon you, brothers and sisters. Welcome back to the Muslim Converse channel. Our current series is an introduction to the 14 infallibles of the Ahlul Bayt. In this lesson, we will be continuing with the lives of the infallibles. We have so far covered Imam Ali alayhi salam and Fatima Zahra alayhi salam. Here, we will continue by briefly discussing the lives of Imam al-Hasan alayhi salam, Imam al-Husayn, Imam Zain al-Abidin, and Imam Muhammad al-Baqir alayhim as-salam. As this is only a 10-minute lecture, our coverage will be naturally limited. Please tune into the further reading list of this lecture for more information. Allah intends only to remove from you the impurity of sin, O people of the Prophet's household, and to purify you with extensive purification. Chapter 33, verse 33 of the Holy Quran. Imam al-Hasan alayhis-salam. Let us begin with Imam al-Hasan alayhi salam. Imam al-Hasan was born in 625 AD and was the second Imam in the line of 12 Imams. His father was Imam Ali alayhi salam and his mother was Fatima Zahra alayhi salam. Naturally, his grandfather was none other than the Messenger of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. One of the features of Imam al-Hasan that stood out was his striking resemblance to the Prophet. The resemblance was so striking that the Prophet Muhammad once stated that Hassan has my form and my nobility. Imam Hassan grew up being raised by Imam Ali and the Prophet Muhammad. In addition to knowledge, he inherited much of the compassion, mercy, and wisdom of his father and grandfather. This wisdom became useful during his short tenure as Caliph. Muawiyah, Imam Ali's arch enemy, had given an ultimatum to Imam Hassan to step down from the caliphate and hand it over to him after bribing his followers to betray him. Imam Hassan, in his compassion for Muslim lives, gave up power in order to avoid bloodshed. Imam Hassan died in the year 670 AD after being poisoned by his wife. His wife was hired by Muawiyah to assassinate him with the false promise of having the opportunity to marry his son Yazid. Imam al-Husayn alayhi salam. Imam al-Husayn was the brother of Imam Hassan and the third Imam. Like Imam Hassan, he was the son of Fatima Zahra and Imam Ali, as well as the grandson of the Prophet. Some of the outstanding traits he inherited from the Prophet Muhammad was his generosity and bravery. The most distinguishing feature of Imam Hussein's life was the event of Karbala. Karbala was where Imam Hussein refused to bow down to the tyrant of his time, Yazid, son of Muawiyah. Unlike his predecessors who subverted Islam behind the curtain, Yazid was subverting Islam publicly. He murdered, led prayers drunk, and would have even recited poetry against the Prophet Muhammad. With all this, Yazid wanted to force Imam Hussein to give allegiance to him, but the Imam Hussein refused. As a result, Imam Hussein was killed along with most of his family. He died in 680 AD. See one of our later lectures on a larger account of Karbala. Imam Zain al-Abidin alayhi salam. Imam Zain al-Abidin was the son of Imam Hussein and was the fourth Imam. Imam Zain al-Abidin means the adornment of worshippers. He was also known as Imam al-Sajjad, the prostrating Imam. He was called such because of his intense devotion to prayer. The Imam was born in 658 AD, and his real name was Ali ibn al-Husayn. He wanted to take part in Karbala, but having been afflicted with a severe illness, he could not participate. In this way, Allah saved his life and kept a living Imam for the Muslim community. Imam Zain al-Abidin alayhi salam lived mostly a quiet life, knowing that involvement in politics would kill him and jeopardize the Imamah on earth. Instead, Imam Zain al-Abidin spent his time teaching Muslims the true nature of Islam and making sure that it took hold on the grassroots level. The Imam could not do this too outwardly, so he taught much through du'as and supplication. Instead, where all of the other major teachings of Islam about God and the religion in general could be found. The most famous compilation of these du'as are called the Sahifa Sajjadiyya. Imam Zain al-Abidin alayhi salam died in 713 AD. Imam Muhammad al-Baqir alayhi salam. Imam Muhammad al-Baqir alayhi salam was the son of Imam Zain al-Abidin and was the fifth Imam. He was born in the year 676 AD. Al-Baqir is a title given to him, meaning the one who opens knowledge. Like his father, Imam Al-Baqir had taken a step back from involvement in politics. He knew at this point it was futile and his arrest or assassination would be a disaster for Islam. The Imam took the necessary approach of staying quiet and teaching Islam to the masses. What was unique about what he started was that he began training people to become scholars of Islam so that they could carry on spreading the authentic version of its message to the Muslims community. As Imam Zayn al-Abidin taught much about correct worship and relations with Allah, Imam al-Baqir focused a lot on the law, making sure that the people understood Islamic law well in a world where so many distortions of the Islamic law had taken place. As such, Imam al-Baqir alayhi salam is credited for laying the foundations of self-contained school of the Ahl al-Bayt. That was to preserve and to teach Islam in all its fullness. For this reason, when one of the companions of the Prophet, Jabir ibn Abdullah al-Ansari rahmatullah alayhi, asked about the names of the Imams who would succeed him, the Prophet replied, "O Jabir, you will have a long life, and although you will go blind, you will meet the fifth in line of my descendants whose name will be my name and who will walk like me and who will be the fifth Imam of my time, of the time. When you will meet him, give my salams to him." The hadith thus demonstrates the important role given to Imam al-Baqir alayhi salam was to play in Islam. In our next lesson, we will cover the sixth Imam until the 11th Imam, inshallah. Until next time, thank you for watching. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.